Hi subscribers and viewers, I want to welcome you back to this channel, this wonderful channel, OWUUBII. Okay, so in this video, I'm basically going to tackle a feature in Mikrotik. And this feature falls under routing. And basically, what I want to achieve is, I want to be able to easily get resources and certain data and services from other networks. Okay, so I'm basically going to do a routing between two networks, so that folks between these two networks can easily share data, resources, and some services between themselves. And this can be done between two and more routers. Okay, so without wasting time, let's deal with the first router. And so this is the router I'm currently connected to, and this is the other router we'll be working on. So let me start with the other router. So where to locate your RIP routing protocol, you need to come to routing, then you will find RIP and the RIP NG, but we are dealing with RIP. Okay, so you go on and add an interface, and I'm using version 2 of the RIP. Okay, and then you apply, you do nothing else, and then you apply. The next thing is to come to networks and add the various networks. So in this case, my local network, this is my local network, which is 9.0. So I need to identify that 192.168.9.0/24. Okay, so meaning any IP under this network will automatically fall under the RIP. The next thing is to add the network of this second router, which is 88 range. So you add it 192.168.88.0/24, then you apply. Now we are done with this first router. You need to replicate the same thing in the second router as well. So in the second router, you locate routing, you go to RIP, and then you add your interface here. Remember, in the previous, this previous router, we were using the version 2 of the RIP. The same way, you need to use the same protocol here as well. So we are using version 2. Then you apply and okay, and then you come to networks and you add the networks. Okay, so in this case 19168.9.0/24, this is the distance network. Then add the local network 192.168.88.0/24, and then you apply. Now we are done with the configuration here. The next thing is to connect to one of the networks and try and see if you can ping between them. So I'm going to connect to my local network, and then we see if we can be able to ping between these two networks. Okay, good. So I've connected my phone to the local network, and my IP is 192.168.88.253. That is the IP I get on my mobile phone. So I need to from here and see if I can reach my mobile phone. If I'm able to reach my mobile phone, it means my RIP settings is successful. Oh, bingo. So I'm able to reach it. So I'm able to reach my mobile phone on a different network. Why? Because I have a routing protocol configured, and this routing protocol is called a RIP. Right? Later you can find out what RIP routing protocol is, and you can find it in most networking devices which have routing capabilities. Okay? So this is basically the means and ways to configure a RIP. Okay, let me take this off from here. Okay, so routes. Okay, so as you can see, it is running. The routing is working. If you come to this place as well, it is also working. Okay, so as you can see, this is what is linking the other router to my local router here. Okay, so it means our routing configuration is successful. Thank you for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe. Make sure to share my videos and like my videos as well, and also don't forget to click on the notification button.